Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Global Women Achievers Festival 2021. I am Nancy Narum, your host for the day. आप जानते हैं क्योंकि सास भी कभी बहू थी, कहानी घर घर की कसौटी जिंदगी में क्या कॉमन था? Of course, कि वो सारे केस से शुरू होते थे, but there is one more thing we can't miss. That's Nivedita Basu, the brainchild behind all these storylines. Welcome to the show, Nivedita.
Hi Nancy, how are you?
I'm fine. So currently you are the director and producer at House of Originals.
Yes.
And you have had the most glorious kickstart anybody could have imagined, because these were serials we have, you know, been hooked on to since the longest time ever. They're the ones which brought the whole concept of family sitting together and, you know, actually living and breathing every character. I still can't forget the day Mihir died and everybody was crying, and you know, there was the next day that was the topic of discussion for everybody. So how did that journey begin, Nivedita?
So, you know, yes, I do consider myself fortunate, but it's pretty surprising that at the time when I joined Balaji back in 99-2000, it wasn't the Balaji. In fact, when I was told to meet Jitendra's daughter, I was like, who is she? What is she doing? You know, so I was coming from a fairly successful place, which was Channel V. You know, at that time, music industry was like Absolutely. At numero uno position. And they said, why don't you do serials? And I was like, what is a serial? You know, so I am not actually somebody who trained in the sense mentally to be in the entertainment industry. In fact, I was studying to be an engineer. So,
wow.
And then of course I switched to filmmaking. So, I mean, of course I did the switch very early, but I wasn't too aware of the daily soap, because daily soaps were not really present back then. If you remember when we were watching Doordarshan in the younger days, it was a weekly thing. You know, you would have Ramayana, Mahabharata on a Sunday, then you would have some show on a Monday. So daily soap kind of started, the advent of daily soap was in the 2000 when I just joined Ekta. And QK had not even started. In fact, we were doing something called Hum Panch.
I'm so sorry. Can you just do the Ki Haanch? I'm so sorry. That's what's
happening. Go on, will you read that?
Line again, please.
So we were doing something for Doordarshan back then, and there was, I think, a fairly popular show called Hum Panch, which was there back in 99-2000, which everyone knows of. So that is the time when I joined, and we did a pilot called Amba, which of course became Kyunki Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi. And then of course there was no looking back. I mean, there was 9 years of K sagas, and I was a part of all of them. I almost did 95 daily soaps with Ekta. So yeah, it's been quite a long journey of 15 years, and I'm quite grateful, and obviously I have a lot of gratitude towards Ekta and God that it made me stay there for that long. And of course we created history with all those soaps. So yes, after 15 years, the whole idea was to switch and do something on our own, which is where House of Originals came to birth. And fortunately, I would say, because I trained to be a director. I mean, back in Channel V, I was a director. Then I was a creative director for 15 years. And then, of course, I did television also as a creator. But now that web has come in, I've turned back to direction, which is why the tag director.
So, Nivedita, now leaving engineering would not have been something that may have been taken too kindly by your parents, because we consider engineering as a very serious field, you know. Now, filmmaking and serials are something that are an entirely different ballgame altogether. So, how was the initial response from your family?
Oh, you'll be shocked. In fact, you'll be shocked that I was the one who wanted to do engineering, and it was the father who actually told me about this course, which was in advertising. So, I think it got a sense that, you know, very a la Three Idiots, you know, I had got admission in Delhi College of Engineering, and I was the only girl student in my mechanical class. So it was like that. And then I think my father kind of gauged, and he said, there's something, you know, that was the first year of advertising and sales in Delhi University, which had come. And he said, well, you want to do that? And I didn't have to think, you know, luckily my parents are very forward minded, and they are the ones who have been like pushing me to do this. But, you know, most of the people don't have that luxury, I know. Everyone has to have a fight to get into media and do the things they want to. So, I mean, it is a fight. It is a fight even when you get into the line. There's never an end to competition. But I think the whole, the only thing which one needs to keep in mind is, of course, willpower and perseverance. If you have that, you can.
I think they must have seen something in you which you probably didn't notice in yourself, and you know, they nudged you towards this field. So
I don't think so. I think he saw boredom in me and the fact that I was with 60 boys in a class and bored.
Yes.
Think that's what probably pushed.
Well, engineering loss was TVS gain. Is what I'm saying.
I wouldn't say engineering's loss because I'm sure there are a lot of legends who are there. But yes, I am quite grateful that my father kind of like paved my way into this line.
Amazing. So, Nivedita, you had the longest run with Balaji and you got your fair share of recognition and, you know, your TRPs were soaring through. So then why did this decision to sort of carve your own niche or do your own thing come into the picture?
So, like I said, see, after 15 years, television was kind of doing the same stuff because the audience doesn't really change, you know. So, even though we are still watching soaps, but the whole idea was that television was going way in the interior, you know. So, after 5 years, it was almost like if I created another show which was similar to the lines of what I created 5 years back, people, there would still be an audience who would say, wow, what are you creating? But for us, you know, mentally it was getting like, okay, I've already done this and I'm again doing it. So I need to kind of like get away from it. And eventually, I mean, that is the whole growth, you know, once you've been working somewhere, the whole trajectory is usually to grow independent and do different stuff. In fact, I'm quite proud that my maiden project as a producer was something not like television. I did the basic biopic of Lata and Asha called Meri Awaazi Pehchaan Hai. Oh. And in fact, that series became one of the most popular. It was a finite series with all film cast and theatre cast. And I mean, I'm so glad that I did it. I mean, I had got calls from all the big filmmakers. I mean, from film, you know, from Sanjay Leela Bhansali to Suraj Barjate, actually saying that they watched something like that. So I think that was the whole intention of switching lines. And then, of course, the bigger picture was obviously to start family after so many years, you know. So I was like, unless I'm on my own, it's very tough to kind of dictate really? Your terms Absolutely. To others.
So unless you,
so I could take
shot,
that time off and yeah. do, you know, like the whole parenting thing, and I'm quite fortunate that I was able to do that.
That's amazing. So Nivedita, when you branched out on your own, what teething troubles did you face? Was it difficult being on your own all of a sudden, or were you sort of mentally prepared for this to happen? What challenges did you face in the future phase?
See, I was quite fortunate actually when I made the switch. In fact, my Rocky brother, he was the one who gave me a show. So it was literally like I switched in March and April, I started my own series. So the first two were not very tough. But if you ask me generally, you know, like for the people who are trying to make the switch, trust me, it's not that easy to do it. You know, when you're in a comfort zone and somebody like an Ekta who's super successful knows and, you know, like knows a way in and out. When you're venturing out on your own, it's very tough, you know, because there is so much competition. There are so many people. There are so many factors which go in, you know, as to why a show is taken from a particular producer and not from another. And then, of course, people also have their favorites. You know, it's very simple. Like if I'm comfortable working with my five people, I would prefer to give it to them, you know, because of the simple reason that I will have a lesser headache and more success. So I understand where people come from and what position, and I feel actually sad also because when I'm on the other side, I feel unfair that, okay, probably I must have done it in my early days and I have to like pay for it now. So television that way was a little tough, like I said, because there's so much competition. TRPs are on a day-to-day basis. So if you don't perform today, you know, it's like tomorrow the channel might be gunning you down. So it was peer pressure, you know, and I was like, okay. And I felt I was way ahead, you know, in my head for the kind of content I was making, and thank God OTT happened, and then it was like it's a playground for me, you know. I can do the stuff and kind of stuff I
and
want.
Also, when you know you're a part of a bigger collaboration, you're only responsible for that particular role that you're playing. When you start your own thing, you become responsible for all the other factors that are going on in that production house. So you have to be responsible for the entire process. So yes, I'm sure that's overwhelming. So Nivedita, how did you then manage that? Because even if it was your own venture, it was still taxing. How did you maintain that work-life balance? You know, you were a mother and then you're the producer. So
See, fortunately in Balaji, like I told you, when I started in Balaji, it was almost like a startup. You know, I mean, we of course see the success story now, 15 years down or 5 years down. So I had done all the things while I was in my learning process at Balaji. So it wasn't very tough. And fortunately, you know, mentally, I've been always very open that, you know, I have not been of the opinion where people say, ye mera kaam nahi hai, I don't want to do this. I am somebody who would just be with a setting guy, pick up tables and this thing just because an artist has to go, you know. So if Smriti had to pack up and go and her all time was going, I would be the one who would go into makeup rooms of actors and say, just come out fast, you know, we have to change and go into the next scene because the actor has to leave. So I have been very flexible and fluid that way. So I don't have any ego issues or anything, you know, to do this, the lower work or the higher up work. So even in my production, I was probably sitting with a costume girl and selecting outfits, you know, for the next scene. And so it was fun also, you know, because earlier you would, I wouldn't say you wouldn't think, because even in Balaji, we were almost like creative producers. We were given a cost to make it in and we were very sure that we would make it in that. So like I said, my training was very good, you know. In fact, a lot of people, when they were earlier joining the entertainment industry, I would tell them, join Balaji, you know, because it's like a good training school. Mm-hmm. On job, there's so much work, you know, so if you don't learn in one, you switch to another. I mean, we were called the factory back then. I mean, at a time, there was a time when we were doing almost 16 daily soaps and I was handling 9 of them.
Wow.
7 were under Ekta and 9 were under me, because Ekta would obviously be creating new stuff and the stuff which would be in the run would come to me. So we've trained on that extreme condition, so it wasn't that bad.
You've had the best training school. So then how did you ensure that you you know, had time for the family and for your kid and for work? How did you juggle between the many roles which I think every woman who's working has to undergo?
See, like I told you, the whole idea of becoming independent was to have that time for yourself and to devote time to your family. And I was just having a child then, you know, during my own production days. So I managed to do that because, see, when you're working with somebody, you can't control time of meeting, their meeting time, their edit time. But in my thing, I could. Plus, I wasn't creating that volume of work. You know, I was doing very limited work. I did one show at a time and that got over, I did the other. And then I actually took a sabbatical for a year and a half from physical work in terms of television. But I was also, in the same time, I was also creating content for OTT, which helps me now, you know. So when lockdown happened and that break happened, I'm actually sitting on a lot of content, and every OTT today needs content, you know. So that's my huge plus now.
So how is OTT working for you? I mean, what new ideas are you churning out?
So I'm so glad OTT came, you know, because television had a lot of reservations in terms of what kind of content you could show. Also,
the language you could
going
use.
Going to the fact that obviously your audience, you know, today when I go to a house and switch on the TV, it's mostly my grandmother or a mother, you know. So the teenagers I'm watching, they're only on their phones, probably seeing YouTube and other things. So OTT opened all those doors for me, you know, because I think very young, I think very progressive, I think out of the box, you know. So those ideas needed a place to showcase, and OTT happened.
So that's amazing. So Nivedita, being a woman and being a woman on the sets and dictating to actors and directing them what to do, you know, how difficult was it? I mean, I've spoken to a lot of people during this course and they say, you know, people usually do not like taking directions from a woman. Did you face something like that?
Yes, I would admit that it is there. See, fortunately for me, unfortunate for the others, a lot of people find me intimidating, you know, because I am quite in command and quite in control, you know. So probably if you ask me on a scale of 1 to 10, if you ask me what kind of difficulty I had, 1 being the lowest and 10 being the highest, I would be only on a 2. I never had a problem, you know, dealing with men that way. But I know my assistants who used to have, you know, my associates would always come to me crying, saying the production guy is, you know, making me cry. He's telling me why. So I knew there were some men in the organization back then who would really get affected by the fact that women are commanding them. But you know, the good part was the bigger boss was also a woman and her mother was also a woman. So we were predominantly a very woman oriented company, so to say, except for obviously the hardcore physical work station which was there, which was of course men, you know. I mean, today I would actually feel happy if I see, you know, women in the light department or women in the camera department more. But they are not there as such, you know. Even women in sport, for that matter, you know, still the sport industry is run predominantly by men. So as a woman, there are problems. But like I said, it's always up to you, you know. When people say that, oh, I feel scared, and they come crying, and I'm like, I cannot do it for you. You know, today I can come and like fire that person and tell him to behave with you today. But other 29 days, you have to be on the set. So you have
tomorrow
to
build that rapport. you know, who could be behaving the same way. So
exactly. So you have to build that within yourself. So we can only help you till a point. After that, it's up to you how you deal with it. You want to be like a tyrant that get on to them, or you want to do it in a more cordial way and earn their confidence and make them believe that you are with them. So I probably did the latter more, you know, more often when I was on the job learning. I always gave them the confidence that it's their idea that I'm putting in, you know, like forward, but obviously pushing my idea, and that made them happy, you know, that I was a team person. And that's how I took my, you know, like my whole woman thing and stride.
So Nivedita, what message do you want to give to women who are waiting out there? You know, you broke the glass ceiling in many ways, and your journey has been nothing short of, you know, a dream come true. So what message do you want to give to women who are watching, who've been your viewers, who are probably waiting for their own turn to make it big into any forte? So what would you like to say to them?
So, you know, fortunately, it's been like 20 years from the time when I started, when it was relatively difficult, you know, for women to come in. But now when I see, you know, like, and I sit in forums and I sit in a lot of educational institutions where I obviously teach, I see a lot of women being predominantly present, especially in my line of work. And when I say my line of work, I'm orbiting more people in my line of work. So my whole reading now of women is that, you know, they've become much stronger. They know exactly what they want. You know, media has exposed them to see what they want to do, you know, in future more clearly vis-a-vis when we did. You know, we had to probably read through what we want to become. Today it's easy to just Google and see, you know, on YouTube, okay, I want to do this. Okay, maybe I don't want to do this. I want to do animation. Maybe I don't want to do animation. I want to do graphics. Maybe I just want to do trailer cutting. So today there are so many super specialization, and I think women are out there. You know, media has done, they say media is being used badly, but I think there's nothing like media. You know, the kind of exposure and learning you get. You know, there was a time when people were told not to allow their kids to watch too much computer, but you know, day before yesterday I went to a eye doctor and he's like, what's the option? Everyone's reading on the computer, you know, because of the pandemic. So things are changing very dynamically, and I'm so glad women have become, you know, they've come out of their fear syndrome and actually doing things which they want to, you know. They found ways to get their parents become confident of what they're doing. You know, there's no war happening, like they would say, you know, like even for marriages earlier, they would say, oh, for marriage, you know, there's like a war happening. So people have found ways to, you know, like make things more cordial and make people understand what they dream of, what they aspire to become. And I'm so glad. I mean, I'm not saying I'm the pioneer or Ekta is the pioneer, but yes, we do look for examples around us, you know, to see, like for me, Ekta was an example, you know. So every time I would feel lazy or I would feel tired that, okay, I want to sleep, you know, it's been like 30 hours, I haven't slept. So I would just look out at Ekta's room and I would see, oh my God, she's working. Damn, I have to like work. So we always find motivation around us. So motivation can come from our parents, like my mother, my father. It can be from your workspace. It can be from your friends, you know, who are doing relatively well in their field. So I think women have found ways to do that. And, you know, they don't feel bogged down by the system or their family or their environment. And they're doing stuff which they want to do. And I'm quite glad that I'm part of the women community, you know, more than men community, like people say, because I think it's more envious to be a woman today and be successful than being a man and being successful.
Absolutely.
Hi, this is Nivedita Basu, and I would like to thank Kshitij Varma and Nancy Narang firstly for hosting me for this very nice talk. It's always very invigorating to speak to intelligent people. The Professional Times and the Indian Media Council for hosting me for such a nice talk. On Women's Day, I would say.
On that note, Nivedita, we would like to thank you for being a part of our show, and we wish you all the luck and love in all your future ventures. Keep creating, keep delighting. Thank you very much.
Thank you.